Structural integrity is still important. And the iPad Pro just doesn't have any of that structural integrity stuff.
Oops! I did it again, baby. Yeah!
What's up, guys? Sal here. So Zach from JerryRigEverything, one of my favorite YouTube channels, did a durability test on the new iPad Pro and showed how easy it is to bend the tablet. He didn't put much pressure at all and the device snapped in half. And you know what's silly? Is people actually defending this. I see everywhere people calling Zach names, saying it's a non-issue, just like they said the iPhone 6 bendgate was a non-issue. By the way, I agree that no one is purposefully bending the iPad with their hands in real life, but did you see how quickly it started to break? It seems to be an amount of force that could easily be applied accidentally in daily life. He could have used a lot less force for it to at least bend, which can in certain cases already be fatal. You're gonna take this device with you, probably in something like backpack or a messenger bag. If the iPad isn't the only thing in a backpack with a regular user, I foresee this becoming a popular issue with those who put this in a backpack without a decent case and don't know how fragile the thing is. Apple advertises this iPad as a device you can take with you, similar to a laptop, day in and day out. I don't think it can handle that. Some of you would say, treat the device like how would you treat any $1,000 plus device. Isn't it reasonable to assume that a $1,000 device would be built like a $1,000 device? And just because you treat the device like a $1,000 device doesn't mean accidents won't happen. Sure, you can reduce the risk, but this is some other level. Also, some of you say, just put a case, problem solved. Why would I spend over $1,000 for the premiumness of a device only to cover with an ugly case? I personally don't like the aesthetic of cases and like to enjoy the product as designed. Steve Jobs specifically called out the reason for the smart covers back in the day. Apple spent so much time designing the form factor of the iPad only to have it covered by a case. So I'm a non-case on phone or tablet kind of guy, and I'm sure a lot of you out there don't like putting cases either. Just remember that if you have to go get a third-party solution to solve a problem, then the manufacturer has failed to make a quality product. In the end, you gotta admit that some design decisions on this tablet are questionable, like putting both the microphone hole and wireless charging dock in the middle, which just makes the structurally weakest part even weaker. Thinness is not the problem, by the way. Thin is good. Structural support isn't going to be any less needed if it was even 2 millimeters thicker. What it just needs is a better reinforcement and engineering. Apple made a good-looking tablet, yet they failed with the design. Let me know what you think about this down in the comments, and I'll see y'all tomorrow. Peace out.